And in this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to make the most disgusting Reese base I've ever made in my life. There's a few things going on here and there's a lot of effects, but I'll walk you through it and I'll show you how to make this absolutely stonky base. First, Oss is going to be using the Serum 2 tables, and it is Harsh Harm. Down 2 octaves. Oss B is also going to be using some Serum 2 tables. This one is called Morpheus, and it's under Digital 2. Nice thick sound to start us off. And lastly, default shapes, 0, yup. Bring that volume down though. And 3 unisons. AC Hum 1 as well. This is where a lot of our noise is going to come from, so yeah. But there's a bit too much low end, so I'm going to make filter 1 just for this one. It's only going to be noise, and it's going to be a high pass filter. Bit of a steeper slope. So yeah, just a lot more control. We're going to come back to that. And that's way too loud. Barely audible at the moment, but once we throw so much distortion and compression against it, you're gonna hear the noise come through, so yeah. LFO 1 is gonna be dragged onto the wavetail position of 2. And we're just gonna be modulating this just a little bit like this. And this is way too fast, so half. Nice. LFO 2, we're gonna add some insane amount of fine tune. 50 will do. This is where the beat frequency is gonna come in, like the nyom nyom sound is coming through, so I'll do it before and after. Everything perfectly in tune, and we're gonna crank this. So it's a little unsettled, and that's where it's getting that Reese sound from. But we're gonna over accentuate that even more, LFO 2 over maybe a couple bars, and I'm gonna drag that onto fine tune and have a bit more action going. So it's getting even more dissonant as it moves away from the perfect tuning. So it's just like, yeah, yeah. And that is that on the main face. The rest is just purely effects, which is where the sound is gonna come alive. It's because it's sounding pretty shit at the moment. anyway, first things first, distortion. We're just gonna crank this. Bit butchered, but it's all good. Next up is gonna be, of course, multi-band compression, multi-band. So we're gonna bump up these notches a little bit. 8 and low end 4.1. We'll dial back the mix a bit because that's a little bit too intense. Next up, chorus to add some funkiness and some width. So that's what it's adding. Very, very strange, but we're going to dial this back a lot. Definitely some more width, some more phasey random shit. Next up, more compression, more multiband. We need some more loudness, apparently. So, 2.7, 10.1. Oh, what am I doing? We need mono and legato and a bit of porter. Still, honestly, a little bit too clean. So we're gonna throw another distortion at it. So more tube. Definitely sounding like a potato. But it is getting there. I think the key to the sound is just a lot of distortion. Anyway, next up is gonna be a filter. And I'm gonna add some formants to this. So miscellaneous formant 1. So we're just gonna be sweeping that sound a little bit more movement. So, like I said, a bit more movement. LFO 2, because this is the slow one. Barely perceivable, but just super, super subtle with those few notches there. Actually, that's way too fast. What am I doing? There we go. Okay, after this, some EQ, get a bit more notchiness, a bit more character. Little peak filter, and then bump that up. Around there. And then... also peak too. LFO 2. Give this some movement. Like so, like so. Bit more. Yeah, okay, I had that round the wrong way. I feel like with the Reese bass, it's similar to like a guitar tone. You want to scoop out all the mids, and by having these notches in the mid section. Next up is just gonna be filter. We're just gonna cap those high ends just a little bit. And of course, that's how you. So just like with or without. A little bit too noisy without, but. Sounds nice and juicy now, weirdly. You want juicy Reese basses, right? A little EQ to give it a bit more treble. Right around there. Not that much. And that is almost it. I realized two essential things. It's not distorted enough, so it means it's not loud enough. So yeah, bump up this. And bump up this. So before. After. There we go, now it's got the sound to it. I forgot to push it hard, and then by making it really loud, you throw it into the tube distortion and it just gets cooked. So. Yeah, very thick, very distorted, very in your face. And yeah, I'd say a key takeaway before this video wraps up is this fine tune throw out. Like if it was just mostly in tune, doesn't have that much rub rub character that Reese basses do. So by bumping that up. Too much. We want like a controlled chaos. And that is a very, very disgusting and thick Reese bass. And the Serum 2 preset sound was part of a very, very large library of Serum 2 presets that I just released called Radium. There's over 150 of them, so if you want to grab them, link will be in the description. Literally just released this the other day. Brand new, and these presets are good for DMB, dubstep, bass house, UKG, etc. Plenty more Serum 2 tutorials to celebrate the release of Radium. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll be back with more Serum 2 tutorials very, very soon. Peace.